At a volcano in the United States, a river of molten rock is flowing into a dense forest, starting wildfires. There are no explosions, no pyroclastic flows, and no thick ash cloud. This is a purely effusive eruption, and a 30-foot-high mass of molten rock is slowly moving across the landscape, advancing at a speed of several hundred feet an hour. You might think that we are in Hawaii, but as we zoom out, you can see that the climate is too cold. Instead, we are at what was once considered the Mount Fuji equivalent in the United States, Mount Saint Helens. Wait, that can't be right. Yet, it is correct, as the date is 105 CE, and we are witnessing the formation of the Ape Cave lava tube. Although the very name of the volcano, Mount St. Helens, invokes scenes of destruction, devastated landscape, and a mountain partially destroyed by a highly explosive volcanic eruption, there was a brief time span when the style of eruption at this volcano was instead quite different. This brief period occurred between 105 CE and 260 CE, when three basalt composition lava flows erupted from the summit and flanks of Mount St. Helens, which would go on to travel up to 9.8 miles from the volcano's summit and runny Pohoihoi lava flows, which may have lasted for several months each. The longest and most voluminous of these primarily effusive, although perhaps moderately explosive eruptions, which may have seen Strombolian eruptive activity occur, created the so-called cave of basalt, which is outlined on screen. This eruption originated from a vent just to the east of the Butte Camp Dome. Due to the topography of the area, primarily a slope tilted downhill to the south, the lava of this vent produced slowly flowed via a series of channels in that direction, creeping over the landscape at a speed of less than 2 miles per hour. After only a few days of eruptive activity, the lava flow thickness had sufficiently increased, allowing for the construction of the lava tube, which likely began as the exterior of the lava flow, now largely inactive, began to cool. Meanwhile, the still-moving interior remained molten, so a sort of underground slow-moving river of lava formed. The structure over time continued to harden as the lava tube supplied lava to more distant locations at the southernmost extent of the lava flow. Eventually, the eruption stopped, leading to the eventual drainage and creation of a lava tube known as Ape Cave. Part of the roof, through more than 1,000 years of erosion, eventually collapsed, allowing for access into what is considered to be the third longest lava tube in the lower 48 U.S. states. For context, only a single lava tube from almost purely basaltic lava fields at Black Butte Crater Lava Field in Idaho and the Indian Heaven Volcanic Field in Washington are longer. The Ape Cave is 2.5 miles in length, occurring in the middle section of the cave basalt lava flow and is consistently 42 degrees Fahrenheit or 5.6 degrees Celsius year-round. A pass is required to park at the site of the cave, warm clothing is recommended, along with bringing two light sources, preferably flashlights per person, with a phone light not counting. But why did this basalt erupt in the first place if during the 40,000-year-long history of Mount St. Helens, this volcanic rock has only erupted during a single 155-year-long period? The answer to this question can be found in the unusual order of compositions produced by eruptions during this period, as not all eruptions during the Castle Creek eruptive period were effusive. As the period started with a highly explosive dacite eruption, followed by a moderately explosive andesite eruption, and only after all that did basalt erupt. Then, this process repeated, with erupted compositions being once again dacite, andesite, then basalt. The cause of this was a phenomenon known as fractional crystallization, which essentially means that over time, as a magma chamber cools, certain minerals crystallize first at higher temperatures and settle to the bottom of a magma chamber. These crystals are associated with lower silica magmas, which makes the bottom change in composition while the top gets more silica-rich. This process can then continue until several different compositions of magma exist in the chamber with the most silica-rich, in this case dacite on top and basalt on the bottom. Thus, when the dacite magma was gone, andesite was next to erupt and then basalt. The magma chamber then refilled and the process repeated. The odds are that a volume threshold has not been met of drained more silica-rich material since this period, hence why basalt lava has not erupted at Mount St. Helens since 260 CE. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank Jim Gravity for becoming a new patron on this channel's Patreon page.